Then perhaps we can move on to the next speaker. Okay, so thank you very much, Professor Kosugi. And the next speaker is Mr. Yamashita from IHI Company. And Mr. Yamashita will be talking on process development for IHI OPT and EFB fuel pellet production. So, Mr. Yamashita, the screen is yours.
Okay. Can you see my slide?
Yes.
Okay. Sude-sensei, thank you for introducing me. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I am.
Just make your slide bigger, you know, it's visible, full screen.
Okay. Bigger. Okay. Okay. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I am Masaharu Yamashita of IHI Corporation from Japan. I'm in charge of development technology and the process for utilizing OPT in this project. Today, I will explain you about our technical history and the newest technical information for OPT processing. First of all, I explain about process flow diagram after developing existing OPT process. This flow diagram is the newest one. Orange symbols are new equipment which Satrips project installed last year, and other has already been installed by IHI. This flow diagram can treat multi-palm biomass like OPT, OPF, EFB, and mescap fiber by same process. All raw material is treated by chipper or extruder. As pre-treatment and washed by continuous dipping tank to recover COD from each biomass and to release potassium and sodium according to principle of osmotic pressure between fresh water and the juice content in each biomass. In case of OPT and OPF, which has log, chipper is first process. And in case of EFV and mescap fiber, which has fiber, extruder is first process. Especially OPF, because OPF has log and leaf, which is formed of fiber, extruder is used as second step. Chipper break out the log of OPT and OPF in 20 to 30 millimeter pieces. Extruder treated EFB and mescap fiber like popcorn by principle of steam explosion in each fiber. Because inner pressure in extruder machine increases to 1 megapascal gauge and temperature is increased 100 degree. Those fiber are defibers in injury. After dipping tank process, all biomass is treated by wet milling called super mascroider to crush them in more finally. In case of OPT, honeycomb structure is parenchyma, is broken, and the sugar content and alkaline content like potassium or sodium are washed out into water and biomass is released to screw press machine as slurry fluid. Then screw press dehydrates those biomass slurries to separate the water's cake and supernatant. Moisture of the water's fiber is about 45 to 50%. After screw press, those the water's cake is dried to moisture of 30 to 50% by drum dryers. After dryer, dried fiber is directly treated by horizontal type ring die pelletizer. This means that fiber cutter is not necessary after dry system because fiber length is already controlled by pretreatment process like chipper, extruder, and wet milling. Compressing ratio of pelletizer die is changed depends on the raw material to be treated. Though raw material is different, the property of the pellets are uniform as follow. Bulk density is 650 to 750 kilogram per cubic meter. Calorie of pellet is 4200 to 4500 kilocalorie per kilogram. Potassium and sodium content are 500 to 1000 ppm and durability are all 98 to 99%. Quality of all pellets are very, very high. This process has another big feature to increase sustainability. It is that their pellets are manufactured by renewable energy, which generated with biogas. From a dipping process and a screw press, primary and secondary juice are discharged. And those wastewater are being treated by methane fermentation process named IHI ICE reactor. And then biogas is produced. Because those OPT juice contain a lot of sugar content, if this process will be installed in a mill or on beside a mill, POME will be able to treat together. COD efficiency of IC reactor is reached 95 to 98%. IC reactor effluent is treated by aerobic wastewater treatment system called MSABP. MSABP is multi-stage aerobic biological process and it has many small tanks. The suitable microorganisms are living in each small tanks and they are various microorganisms like from bacteria to protozoa. Because various microorganisms are living in each small tanks and higher microorganisms eat lower one, surplus sludge production rate will be minimized. In this point, sustainability of this process become higher. After MSABP, two kinds of membrane filter system are installed. One is MBR to separate suspend solids from MSABP effluent. And the second is RO to concentrate MBR effluent. Because MSABP effluent contain a lot of nitrogen, phosphate, potassium, and magnesium, which become fertilizer components. Concentrated water is able to utilize as liquid fertilizer. And treated water is reused as fresh water for dipping process and wet milling process. And those membrane C system are used to concentrated OPT juice after direct squeezing OPT and OPF. Concentrated OPT juice has about 20% sugar content, and this is used as various intermediate materials. In this page, we can see each equipment photograph from chipper to pelletizer, which are used to make biomass pellets. That equipment are real size machine and can make pellets of 1 to 2 ton per hour, excluding dryer system. That equipment has been installed to check maximum performance of each machine. Therefore, that equipment can be used for full-scale plants because we have a lot of experience and scale-up know-how about IC reactor and MSABP, wastewater treatment system, which consists of IC reactor and MSABP, has been designed and installed as smaller size reactor. Those are new membrane system. Treatment capacity is 100 cubic meter per day for each. This size membrane system is designed and installed as pilot plants to take engineering data for full scale. But this system can be fully MSABP effluent. This is an extruder, which is designed and installed to leaf fiber EFB, MCF, and leaf of OPF. This machine has a twin screw system for compressing fiber inside the casing. Inside the casing, fiber is compressed to 1 megapascal and temperature reached to 100 degree. When fiber is released to outside through small hole, water inside fiber is expanded and the steam explosion appear. Then fiber structure is destroyed from inside. This time, a part of hemicellulose is decomposed and the binder component is expressed. EFB pellet manufactured by this system become strong, but EFB pellet manufactured by normal process doesn't become strong. This effect is effective for all biomass, and we can decrease compressing ratio of pelletizer dye in 1 or 2 stage. This means that this system can decrease pelletizer's power. Those photographs are B55 type of extruder. As upper grade, B19 type is designed and manufactured for full-scale up EFB plants in Sarawak. This scale-up EFB plant will be started from the end of November in 2021. Each capacity of B55 and B19 is 1 ton per hour and 3 ton per hour, and designed under 50% moisture. In this slide, I explain about advantage of our CoolAmp OPT process. All heat and power to manufacture biomass pellets is supplied by utilizing biogas, which generated by IC reactor. Almost 100 COD from sugar content in OPT juice is recovered by dipping system, wet milling, and screw press. If whole OPT is treated, because big amount of biogas is recovered, and surplus power remains after utilizing them. That means because of all power and all heat supplied to process from renewable energy, which generated from biogas, we can call our process zero emission process. Second advantage point is that our process can keep quality of pellet high. This means that potassium and sodium concentration are kept low concentration by effect of dipping process, wet milling, and screw press. Please see figure 1 and figure 2. We can understand concentration of potassium, sodium, and chlorine are dropped in two steps, and that concentration are as same as PKS. PKS is utilized as one of fuels for biomass boiler in Japan. And ash content of OPT pellets after wet milling process is lowest, and caloric value of pellets is as same as others. This figure is prepared to explain that various sperm biomass can be treated by one process combined extruder into existing OPT process. As mentioned above, OPT and OPF, which has log, are treated by CHIPPA as first process, and EFB and MESCAC fiber, which has fiber, are treated by extruder as first process. In case of OPF, because OPF has leak, extruder is used to treat leak as second process. Wet milling has two stones on the top and the bottom. Control point of wet milling is adjustment of clearance between upper stone and lower stone. This is adjusted according to the characteristic of each biomass here. But exchanging of stone for each biomass is not necessary, and we can use the stone which design and manufactures for OPT processing. Control of CHIPPA, continuous dipping, screw press, and dryer for EFB, OPF, and MESCAC fiber are as same as OPT. And the compressing ratio of pelletizer is adjusted according to characteristic of fiber after dryer. Complexing ratio of pelletizer in case of mulching process is designed lower than that in case of a normal process. Next, I show you each photograph in each biomass processing. These photographs are for EFB processing. Low EFB fiber looks hard and intertwines. Then EFB fiber after extruder looks softer than before, and they are changed to softer and more defibering step by step. A wet milling to dryer. As a result, pelletizer manufacture pellets, which has high bulk density of over 800 kilogram per cubic meter. As above mentioned, we can understand that the compressing ratio of pelletizer may be changed to lower one. These photographs are for OPF processing. OPF is treated to crush log of OPF by CHIPPA as first step. And the leaf of OPF is treated by extruder as a second step. Fiber after extruder looks softer and more defibering in step by step from wet milling to dryer too. As a result, Pelletizer manufacture pellets, which have high bulk density of 800 kilograms per cubic meter. And we can understand that the compressing ratio of pelletizer may be changed to lower type 2. Those photographs are for MESCAP fiber processing. MESCAP fiber has similar characteristic of fiber to EFB, and fiber length is long and looks intertwined. But MESCAP fiber pellet is manufactured by comparatively high compressed pelletizer. And because oil content includes in MESCAP fiber, when MESCAP fiber after extruder treatment is treated by dipping process, oil content extracts into dipping water. We can recover the oil content from MESCAP fiber dipping water by decanter like POME, because CPO can be recovered from MESCAP fiber by this process, mill can increase income more. Those are photographs for processing of hybrid pellets between EFB fiber and OPT parenchyma fiber. Because normal EFB fiber does not have binder content to manufacture good pellets, we try to manufacture EFB OPT hybrid pellets by aging parenchyma as binder, and we have succeeded to manufacture hybrid pellets in EGD. I will explain later about the reason why we have tried to manufacture hybrid pellets with parenchyma of OPT. Those are photographs for OPT processing. OPT fiber looks much different from another biomass. Raw fiber is log itself, and there are two kinds of fiber. One is bascule bundle. Second is parenchyma. Those mixed fiber is treated by chipper and wet milling to crush and to average. Dipping process and wet milling process work to control the concentration of potassium and sodium at the lower level. OPT pellet is manufactured by this process in Italy. This diagram is designed for separation of parenchyma and bascule bundle by optimizing cyclone system of dryer. Bascule bundle fiber, which separates by this process, will be utilized as material fiber instead of wood chip. OPT process has cyclone as a part of dryer system, and cyclone can collect mainly parenchyma. Big size of fiber, including vascular bundle, is collected and discharged from dryer. We have succeeded to separate two kinds of fiber by only controlling flow rate of ID fan after cyclone is property. Vascular bundle fiber is pelletized with low compressing dye to remain shape of fiber in pellets. In parenchyma fiber, pelletized with middle compressing dye for utilizing as biomass fuel, because fiber size in parenchyma OPT pellets is very fine and average. This pellet is very suitable to utilize as biomass fuel for co-fire with coal. In this slide, I want to explain about economic effects by mulching process. Figure one is FFB amount data per each month in standard mill FFE of 60 tons per hour is proceeded. We can see that FFE amount harvested from palm plantation is fluctuated per season. This fluctuation puts a limit on design capacity of EFE processing by engineer. If plant capacity is designed on maximum FFE amount, 100% of EFE fiber is being pelletized. But because equipment utilized rate per 1 year may be lower, investment efficiency will not become higher. On the other hand, if plant capacity is designed on maximum FFE amount, equipment utilization rate per year may be already 100%, but EFE pellets production amount may become minimized. Here, I can explain this program on engineering will be solved by mulching process as follows. When the EFE amount is lower than design capacity, another biomass like OPT, OPF, and the mesh fiber can be able to put in this process. In this case, equipment utilization rate per year will be always 100%, and production amount will be kept at maximum according to design capacity. As a result, engineer can design maximum capacity press without worrying about investment efficiency. This figure is material balance in 60 ton FFP processing per hour. In per year, 308,000 ton in proceeded in this mill. These FFP are harvested from palm plantation with a diameter of 6.5 kilometer and transported to mill. When OPT to 100,000 ton per year and OPF of 100,000 ton per year are collected from this area, total biomass pellet production amount will be reached 100,000 ton per year by this process. Because existing EFP process can manufacture only 10,000 ton per year, we can understand that this new process is a breakthrough technology on biomass pellet manufacturing industry. This means that this process gives us a lot of economic benefit and environment benefit that GHG reduction amount is increased, is giving us. And the palm mills can also use renewable energy produced by IC reactor from max wastewater of biomass juice like POME and OPT juice. This means that CPO is produced with 100% renewable energy. This table is prepared to explain that how much increased income is and that how much decreased GHG amount per 1 mil by this new process. I assume following unit numbers as a base of calculation. CapEx of new process installation, 3.0 billion yen, which is calculated based on Japan. CapEx calculated in Malaysia may be cheaper. Exchange rate between US dollar and Japanese yen is 108.7 yen per US dollar. Selling price of CPO is 622.747 US dollar per ton CPO. Selling price of biomass pellet is 15,000 yen per ton at Japan Port CIF. Renewable energy generated from each biomass is assumed to use instead of coal. GHG emission coefficient of coal is 0.71 ton carbon per ton coal. If each biomass and the pome will be not treated in properly, almost all COD which involved in biomass and pome assumed to be changed to methane by anaerobic fermentation. As a calculation result, per 1 mL, return is increased 1.31 times higher than current. And the GHG reduction amount is 50 times bigger than current. Now, this table is prepared to explain about global GHG reduction. As a calculation result, total GHG reduction amount is 1.3 billion tons per year. And this amount is as same as Japan GHG emission amount in 2030. Moreover, 19.34 billion US dollar per year will be assumed to be increased as return. If this new process will be applied to all palm milk in Malaysia and in Indonesia, they can obtain many merits by selling very suitable palm oil in worldwide. And I think that all companies who use palm oil for business activity should take care of the problem which palm oil industry have, and they should invest to solve environment issues. As a result, their good brands will become higher than before. And thank you for attention.
Okay, thank you very much, Mr. Yamashita from IHI. Very, very comprehensive and interesting